This animation will provide a step-by-step guide through your microbiology experiment and focus on the principles of Koch's postulates and how they relate to microorganisms causing disease. Make sure, before you start any laboratory experiment, you ensure that you are wearing your lab coat, gloves, and goggles in order to protect yourself from harm and stop the spread of contamination. The first step of the experiment is to inoculate your apple. You're provided with a clean, healthy apple that you will divide into 6 segments. You've also been provided with penicillium expansum that has been originally isolated from a rotten apple. Label the first segment of your apple A1 and using a sterile needle knife, remove some of the penicillium spores and touch the surface of the apple with it. Label the second segment A2 and using another sterile needle knife, stab the spores into the apple 3 mm deep. You're also going to inoculate the apple with a bacteria, E. coli, to determine whether only the penicillium is causing the disease or other organisms are too. Label the segment B1 and touch the surface of the apple with a sterile needle knife carrying E. coli. Label another segment as B2 and stab the apple 3 mm deep with a sterile needle knife carrying E. coli. The final 2 segments are going to act as a control and not contain any microorganisms. Label the first segment C1 and stab the apple with an alcohol sterilized needle knife to ensure it has no microorganisms. Label the final segment, C2, and leave it untouched. Place the inoculated apple into a polythene bag plus a wad of damp cotton wool to provide it with humidity. Incubate this at 25 degrees to allow for microbial growth. In order to meet Koch's first postulate, penicillium expansum must show signs of rot and be present in the rot. Once your apple has exhibited some rot, you will need to identify the microorganism causing the growth. There are 2 main methods to do this. The first is to conduct a sellotape peel. This is used for fungal microbes. The second is to conduct a gram stain. This is used for bacterial microbes. How to look for fungal growth. Firstly, a small strip of sellotape and firmly place it on top of a fungal colony. Then, remove the sellotape and place it sticky side down on a microscope slide, that is, a drop of methylene blue on it. Allow for the stain to be taken up by the spores and view the slide under a microscope, and you will be able to view spores and specific features such as cnidophores to identify your bacteria. It is essential to know whether they are gram positive or gram negative. To find this out, you will conduct a gram stain. To do this, use a sterilised loop to transfer your bacterial sample onto a clean slide and hold above a Bunsen flame to fix the specimen in place on the slide. Then, dip the entire slide in crystal violet solution and rinse off any excess. Then, dip the slide in iodine solution and allow it to stand for 1 minute and remove any excess. Next, dip the slide in safranin for 45 seconds and blot it dry. You can then view this under a microscope. If the bacterial sample is purple, this means it's gram positive. If the sample is red, this means it's gram negative. Now that your apple is exhibiting high amounts of rot, you need to isolate the microorganism causing the disease and grow it in pure culture. This is the second of Koch's postulates. To do this, retrieve your apple and using a sterile needle knife, carefully dissect out 2 small cubes. These should be 5 mm by 5 mm by 5 mm in size. The first one should be taken far from any rotten area of the apple, and this should act as a control. The second should be taken from the edge of the rotted region. Cut these squares into 5 pieces and place on PGA petri dishes. Make sure to do the control plate first to prevent contamination. Then incubate these at 25 degrees. The final step of the experiment is to re-inoculate a new healthy apple with your isolated fungus. To do this, take a sterile needle knife and pick up a fungal specimen and insert it into the apple. so it goes 3 millimetres deep. If there is rot observed on the apple, then this supports Koch's third postulate that the pathogen grown in pure culture must cause disease when inoculated into a healthy, susceptible lab specimen. Koch's final postulate states that the organism isolated from the experimental host must be identical to the original causative agent. Thank you for watching.